Okay, welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to start your floor plan, mainly beginning with the exterior walls. At this point, you should have your spreadsheet already prepared with your different layers of your wall, like your drywall, your framing, your insulation, OSB sheathing, vapor barrier. And whatever, if you have airspace, you need to account for that thickness, and also you need to have your bricks. You need to have all those materials already listed on a spreadsheet. And then, of course, according to all the different columns and rows and stuff on that spreadsheet. And of course, you should have already been shopping for that material. Shopping on the website to places like Lowe's, Home Depot, or even the manufacturer themselves, going straight to the manufacturer, whoever makes the drywall, whoever makes the bricks, and getting the specification on that material. And there's lots of different specifications. Right now, we're mainly concerned with thickness of the material, and that is so that we can, kind of lay out our exterior shell of our building. So, what we're going to do first, you want to go up here to your okay. First, you want to go up here to your application menu, and open that up, and then go to drawing utilities and units, and of course, change your units. I'm going to change those to architectural. Okay, next you'll come over here to your layers and you'll create your five different layers, starting with your five different layers. There will be more to come, but right now you just need five. Name those layers. You can name the first one EXTW for exterior wall. Oops, I didn't type anything. EXTW for exterior wall. And label them just like I'm labeling them here. INTW for interior wall. And of course, depending on who you work for, you'll have different protocols that you'll have to follow. But this is just going to be the classroom protocol. So we got exterior walls, interior walls. We want door. Window, just put wind, and then casework. We'll just put case. Casework, if you don't know, casework is your cabinetry. That is your shelves, your cabinetry, and everything that goes in the home. So everything there goes on that layer. Now we need to assign colors. And two, if we needed to change the line width, we would do that as well. But we're not going to change that just yet. We are going to use some line widths, but we're going to use it per line rather than per layer. So I need red for my exterior walls, and you'll need to color yours the same way as I'm coloring mine. Interior walls, green, and I just use the basic colors right here to make it simple. Door, it's going to be yellow. Wind, or windows, gonna be this light blue. And then your casework, do purple. And then on subsequent layers that come after this, I'll give you a little bit more freedom choosing colors and things like that. But for right now, we need these to be those primary colors. Right. So we have our layers, and of course we're going to start with our exterior walls. So we'll double click on that to make that active. And as you see here, this shows our active wall layer right here, our active layer, I should say. And it says, and of course, if I want to make anything else, another one active instead of the exterior wall, let's say I go to do the interior walls, I just click on that and make that active. So here we are, we're going to use exterior walls first. And this is going to be a very basic floor plan that I'm doing. Yours is going to be maybe a little bit more complicated, and I want you to make up your mind how you want your house footprint to look. Do not draw it just like I'm drawing mine. because I'm just going to draw really small. It's not even going to meet the specifications of the project. But I'm going to start with 20 foot in the X, tab over to the Y, and 15 foot. Okay, so basically kind of a rectangular house here. And there we go right there. Right. Now, this is basically the exterior. This is the part that's exposed to the weather. Now I need to represent my layers going down. Now we're going to do this in great detail, even though many times you're going to find drawings where they do not use the actual layer detail. They actually have like a standard wall sizes that they use for exterior brick or exterior regular siding and interior walls, but we're going to go ahead and go through the motions of the exact detail to get us an exact wall thickness and depth. So, and it's very important to have this exact thickness so that when you're building everything in the house, you go in to put cabinets and what have you, everything measures up correctly and you don't run out of space or have too much space to fit certain things where they need to go. So here we are. We're going to offset this exterior line. We're going to offset it the thickness of our bricks. Okay, now you need to set this to the thickness of the material that you choose for the outside of your house. If your bricks are 4 3/8 inches wide, then that's the way you need to set it. Okay, I'm just going to go make things real simple here, and I'm just going to say 4 inches. Okay, now those are my bricks. The next layer is going to be my airspace. So I'm just going to keep things going just like they are, and I'm going to click on that line to offset that one again, but I'm going to change the distance to 1 inch. It's going to be my 1 inch airspace between my brick and my sheathing. Okay, next I have my sheathing and my vapor barrier, which I'm just going to include them all in one. And that's going to be 3/4 of an inch. All right, and then I have my framing. My framing is going to be 3.5 inches, as we've always discussed before, in the finding the thickness of our 2x4s. And then, of course, we have our drywall on the inside, typically around 1/2 inch. So we're going to offset this line 1/2 inch. Okay, so now there's all of our wall layers. That's how I want you to do your exterior walls, just to kind of practice doing this. Later, you won't have to do this, and actually, on your interior walls, I'm not going to make you layer them like this, but it's important to do this. Here's the main reason why. I'm going to measure this, and you're going to see my exact wall width. Oops, well, not that way, you're not. Let me turn off my snaps. Okay, so where did my ruler go? There it is. Okay, all the way to the inside. So basically, my walls are 9 15/16. Might as well go ahead and say 10. So basically, I have 10-inch walls. That's going to be a very accurate measurement. And that's going to allow for, less tolerance when it comes to building other things within the house, when it comes to putting the inside walls together, when it comes to putting cabinets between walls, all that kind of stuff. Everything's going to be more closely measured, and it's going to be a higher quality design. Now, the other way of doing this is basically just drawing the exterior and the interior line and spacing those according to your wall thickness. And even still, you will come across situations where companies use just a standard wall thickness, like, okay, it's an exterior wall with brick, we're just going to go make it 9 inches. It's an exterior wall with vinyl siding, we're just going to draw it at 6 inches. Okay, so you will come across that, and that's actually most of what you would see. But we're going to go ahead and go through the details here. For one, so we can get practice, and two, because if you go to work for someone really good, they're probably going to have you do that. So here we next thing we want to do is to kind of separate these areas by hatching. We're not going to do a lot of hatching. I am going to represent my bricks with a diagonal line right here, And I'll actually scale that up. I think it last time I did this, it was around 8-inch scale or 7.8. That worked good too. And I click inside there. Any minute now, I should actually get a hatch. There we go, finally. All right, so I got my hatch. And then, of course, you got your airspace right here. Some people will color that blue, but it's really not necessary in this application. And the next thing you have is your different layers, your timbers, your drywall, and your other stuff here. And we're not going to layer in it because it's really small. I mean, layer. We're not going to hatch in it because it's really small. But I do like the bricks being hatched such as so. So anyway, that's how you make the exterior shell of your walls.